Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna have a little fun and read some one-star reviews of best-selling products from Sephora's website. If you're watching my videos, if you watch other beauty gurus' videos or tutorials, you are obviously part of the beauty community. And even though we deal with beauty, sometimes shit gets ugly. And a lot of times, if you share a negative review about a product, people can get really defensive. Like, if you diss someone's best loved product, they can get really sensitive about it. Obviously, the point of a makeup review is to share your experience. And I thought today we could celebrate one star reviews, being that one nail that won't get bashed down by the negativity, and voicing your opinion, putting yourself out there. Here we are on Sephora's website, and I'm under the heading Bestsellers Makeup. And you can take a look at some of the products that obviously are really good performing products. A lot of people love them, but obviously it's makeup, right? It's not gonna work for everybody, so let's search out some less than stellar reviews. The very best selling product right now at this moment, a lot of conversation up about it, is the Subculture eyeshadow. I'm gonna skip that. Let's go back to Modern Renaissance, shall we? This is a review by Krista Guan, and she says, nope. Everybody hyped this palette up, so it had high standards to fill. It didn't. Once I forgot about the standards the best I could, I realized I wouldn't even buy it drugstore priced. Patchy and weird looking on the eye, and why can palettes just have a straight red instead of oranges, hot pinks, and oranges? This warm colored palette was cool toned. Everything looked like a patchy bruise. Gave it to my sister and even she thought it was bad. And as you can see, nobody thought that review was helpful, everybody thought it was bad, and girl just wants some red tones. Next we have Urban Decay's Naked Heat palette, kind of another controversial palette, and this palette is a very warm nude palette. And we have a review from KG123. She gave it 1 star and says, swatches look very red. Colors are great, but was hoping for more of a copper or burnt orange palette. The shades look much more red and orange on the skin than I was hoping. And 6 people found that review helpful. A whopping 71 people shut her down. So I don't know if she said what she had to say. People don't agree with that. But that comment definitely generated some heat. Next, a concealer product. This is the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer, $37 Canadian. My Lark gives it a 1 star and she says, overall a bad product. She says, I'm a teenager and of course I don't get much money, but if I do, it's Christmas or birthdays, but I needed a new concealer and I wanted to go all out because the one I had been using before was very low-end drugstore, but it still got the job done. This product, however, didn't. I got this in late December and it's now April and almost out. I don't have money to waste on 3 months of product for $40 and I wear this concealer 4 to 7 days a week. I was literally considering the fact that it could be a fake because I don't understand how so many people can rave about this terrible product. I'm literally a teenager and it makes me look like I have wrinkles. It doesn't cover my dark circles nor my blemishes. For this product to be $40, it's gonna have to be my holy grail, my God, my religion, something I swear my life on, and TBH, it's quite the opposite. Amazing review there. One person found that helpful, 2 people found that not helpful. I thought that was very helpful. And kudos for her for saying what she feels. So I'll move on to the Urban Decay All Nighter Long Lasting Makeup Spray, a $39 product. And we'll read Jill XO's review. She gives it 1 star and the review is called Why. Why is this rated so high? It literally does nothing. I continued to use the same spray for the last several months because I liked that it made my foundation look less cakey after spraying my face. But this does nothing to make it last longer and it doesn't keep makeup from melting off your face. I've tried spraying on top of my face makeup and I've also tried spraying it after primer, then spraying it again after foundation is applied. Still no stain power. Don't bother wasting your money. Instead, get the Mist and Fix from Makeup Forever. That one actually makes your makeup transfer resistant and long lasting when sprayed underneath and on top of foundation heart. Let's try another classic foundation. This is the Estee Lauder Double Wear Stay in Place Makeup, a $48 foundation, and one that I really love. So we're gonna read George 1977's review, and it's rated 1 star, and the review is called Define Cakey. This foundation was the first high-end foundation I was ever introduced to, so I thought it was okay. Better than some drugstore ones. Once I tried some other high-end foundations, I figured out the truth. The foundation is blotchy, dry, and it always changes color. I hate this foundation. The worst thing, though, is that it is so cakey. No matter how much you use, it's gonna look like your makeup is so thick that you have to remove it with a butter knife. I do not recommend this to anyone except for the extremists. If you are looking for a foundation that will cover up anything, this is your guy. And nobody claims to have found that review helpful. Five said it was not helpful, but I think George 1977, props to you for putting it out there. This is the Giorgio Armani Beauty Lip Maestro, and this is a $43 lip stain. SK42 says, embarrassed in public, and gives it a 1-star review. Quick take, it's treacherous. So, I wore this on a casual day in the city and was highly disappointed to find that it had migrated across my mouth. My dining companion suggested I go to the bathroom to fix it, where I discovered that it had somehow gotten on my nose. Normally, I am not in the position to be critical of anything produced by Giorgio Armani, but this is truly a travesty. Save yourself the humiliation, do not buy. And 3 people appreciated that review. 1 person had the audacity to say that that review was not helpful. I think especially a lip stain, it can't be moving around like that. Next, the Too Faced Better Than Sex Mascara. I've done a full review on that if you guys want to check it out. This is a $30 mascara, and this is from Nene007, or 007. 1 star. Displeased after 2 tries. Don't know if I have the worst luck ever or if this mascara hates me. Bought this a few years ago and quite simply didn't go on as advertised. Clumped on lashes and the end of the brush like crazy. I returned it and was later told by several people that it needed to touch air a few times before it worked as well. But as someone who replaces mascara like clockwork every 3 months, I don't have the time to wait for it to work, especially not at this price point. However, people still raved about it, so I gave it another go, this time in travel size, to not risk as much money. This time, the application process was better, and I pulled the wand out a few times before using it while watching TV to let it breathe, and that seemed to work. Then again, maybe it was just a dry batch, because both times I used it, after less than an hour, it was flaking off below my eyes and on my eyelids without me rubbing my eyes. The first time I blew it off as a fluke, but it happened again. Maybe it sat on the shelf too long, but I am done trying. We'll be trying to return it. And all I can say is, girl, you shouldn't have to work that hard to make your makeup products work for you. Here is kind of an oldie, but I guess it's still a bestseller. The Too Faced Sweet Peach Eyeshadow Collection Palette. This is a $60 palette. Izzy Yu gave it a 1-star review. She says, I got this palette the day it came out last spring. I think I have used it 4 times. The color selection is sad, almost every shade is patchy, they are chalky and very unpigmented. Even with a primer, most shades get muddy and it looks like a mess. It is borderline drugstore and is honestly not worth your money. Was this review helpful? 2 people said yes, 5 people said unhelpful. I salute you, Izzy Yu, for having your say. Next, we have the Kat Von D Everlasting Liquid Lipstick, kind of a cult classic. These are $24 liquid lipsticks from MJ Chillier, and she says, not transfer proof, 1 star. I really like the color, but I have a white dog, and I kiss it, and it left it dirty, sad face. 2 people claim to have found that review unhelpful. They must not have white dogs. Okay, last product here, having too much fun. This is another Giorgio Armani product. This is the Giorgio Armani Beauty Luminous Silk Foundation, 1 ounce, $68. And this review is from Duat98. 1 star, absolute worst. My drugstore foundation works better than this. It doesn't dry down and just sits on my face rather than sinking into my skin. Any attempt to blend will result in streakiness and cakiness. I don't understand what the hype is about. After applying this thing and ruined my makeup for the day, I actually had to wash all my brushes because any brush that touched this foundation clumped and caked up my face. The range of color was not impressive. They all have a lot of red and peach undertone. If you have a lot of yellow undertone like me, I would suggest skipping this. 10 people found that helpful. 10 people claim to have not found that helpful. And that is my quick video today. This is reading 1-star reviews of Sephora bestseller makeup products. What is the lesson that we learned today? I guess it's just don't be afraid to leave a crappy review even if people get offended or feel threatened by it. There is definitely a space for you to put your opinion on makeup out there on the internet, especially when it comes to makeup, because literally no one is getting hurt. And you could help someone out with your review if they have like similar skin or a similar experience. So I do find a lot of the times, maybe especially in YouTube reviews, and it kind of was highlighted with the whole subculture controversy, that a lot of times people are really quick to blame the consumer for using the products incorrectly. Which on one hand, like, yeah, okay, if you totally mess up or you use it for an unintended reason, I could see why there could be criticism. But that being said, we don't always buy products for the intended reason, and we are under no obligation to use makeup products the same way, right? And while some of these reviews got some downvotes, that should never stop you from putting out your review. And wouldn't you agree that reading negative reviews is sometimes more helpful than reading positive reviews? Anyway guys, hope you enjoyed spending this time with me. Make sure you go out and review that one product that you really dislike. Get your voice out there, say something about it, speak up. Let me know what you guys think of the comments down below. Let me know if you guys leave reviews about products you love particularly, or products you hate particularly, or when you're buying something, do you just read the positive reviews, or do you also switch it up and read like the most negative reviews? I'm definitely interested in reading what you guys have to say. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure you give this a thumbs up. Subscribe down below if you'd like to see more beauty related content from me. Make sure you share this video with anybody else who might find it interesting. And aside from that, I will see you all tomorrow in my next beauty video. Bye.